Hello beautiful people, how are you? Welcome once again to the channel. Thank you so much for clicking. Thank you for stopping by. This is a happy family. So if you are new and this is your first time clicking to the video or to the channel, you are highly welcome to Explore with Bolu. Please make sure you consider subscribing to the channel. We are beautiful people here and we love to welcome you. Anyways, for my returning subscribers, thank you so much, so much. I love you guys so much, more than my heart can take. Thank you for always coming back. And welcome to this new video. Today, as you have seen the title, we'll be talking about my country. Yes, my country. You guys are the ones that requested for it. So, and I'm going to just be telling you the basic things and just introduce my country to you and the simple truths. I hope I won't get emotional in this video. Anyways, if you are interested in seeing the end of this video, then watch till the very end to get the main gist. Let us begin the video right now. Okay, so yeah, welcome back. Today we'll be talking about Nigeria. Nigeria is a beautiful country, by the way. I'm proud of my country. That's just the truth because I am a Nigerian, right? No matter the challenges, no matter the situations you may be facing anyway, definitely we all have where we come from, okay? Where we have come from. And of course, I cannot claim any other place. The only thing I can do is to actually see that things get better from my own place, okay? But by the way, I'm a Nigerian, and Nigeria is actually located in the western part of Africa. Okay, Africa is a continent, a very big continent, just like Asia. You guys have Asia, right? Then you have Malaysia, you have China, you have Japan. So it's similar to what we have over there. We have Africa, very big continent. Then we have Nigeria, we have Ghana, we have Ivory Coast, we have Cameroon, you know, a lot of countries, South Africa, Sudan, you talk of Somalia, you talk of Egypt, you know, you talk of Kenya. These are different countries, Tanzania, these are, and many more, okay? These are different countries that exist in Africa. So I am from Nigeria, which is like the Western Africa, West Africa, basically. And what do you guys want to tell you about my countries? Because I told you guys to give me ideas of videos you want us to do during this period of the MCO, because currently in Malaysia, there's a new MCO. MCO means movement control order, okay? Which means movement will be restricted, cannot really travel inter-district, you cannot travel interstate. So like, we cannot really travel so much. That's what I'm trying to say, to give you all those wonderful content from outside. So for now, we have to diversify our content a little bit and go back to some discussions kind of content. Maybe I'll come up with live videos. Let me know in the comment section below what do you want me to do. I'll also be trying some foods, and I'll try to cook also during my spare time if I have the time. Okay, so these are some of the interesting videos you're going to be seeing. If you want me to do some challenges, you can also let me know in the comment section below. But let's not get distracted from this video. We're talking about Nigeria today, and am I really proud to be a Nigerian in the real sense? Well, Nigeria was actually independent according to the history. Nigeria gained our independence on what, 1st October 1960. And definitely before that, we were being, ruled by the British colony. But after that period, just at 1st October 1960, we got our independence as a nation. And what's the meaning of independence? Independence supposed to mean freedom, am I right? Definitely it's supposed to mean that the country should be free and we're supposed to be better than what we were then, right? But is that the case? That's the question all Nigerians will ask, okay? That's the question all Nigerians will keep on pondering on, that even though we are now an independent nation for how many years now, you know, what has really changed in our nation for over 50 years? What has really changed in our nation? And it's a very quite pathetic situation, if you may ask me, because it's not hidden, and there are some things that doesn't need to really be you know, conjoint, or this kind of maybe want to hide something or say, oh no, this country is very great and all that. You see, the way I explore Malaysia genuinely, and I show you guys the raw, real fact about Malaysia. Am I right? So, and which you can ask anybody that is sincere enough, a foreigner in this country, to tell you about, they will give you the full, description about how Malaysia really looks like, you know, in reality. So, coming back to my country, I love my country so much. Definitely, one of the major reasons why I love my country is because of the loved ones that are there. Of course, that's one of the major reasons, am I right? And of course, because I'm also a Nigerian, I cannot deny that fact. It's the Nigerian passport I used to come here, and that's what I'm going to use to be able to travel everywhere. So, yes, I am still a Nigerian, okay? Except if the name changes in the future. But it's not about the name changing. What we are more concerned about as Nigerians currently is the situation in the country, which I would like to tell you guys, you know. Not like I'm not proud of my country, maybe to bring content about Nigeria or stuff like that, but definitely I'm here in Malaysia at this time. So, of course, you expect me to give you current information of where I am, right? That's why I'm exploring Malaysia. And those who may explore Nigeria, definitely there'll be people that are living in Nigeria currently. And those who may be giving news, I'm not a news channel, okay? Those who may be giving news, and those who be giving news about the happenings in Nigeria, whether good or bad. But for me, I'm just an explorer. But since you guys requested for the video, I'll tell you a little bit about my country. Nigeria has a lot of touristic areas, because many of you asked about, should tell you about the tourist opportunities in Nigeria, tourism opportunities in Nigeria. Yeah, Nigeria has very nice touristic places, if I may say, in different parts of the country. In the middle belt, in the capital, Abuja is the capital of Nigeria. There are a lot of beautiful places there. You want to talk about the south, there are a lot of historical places in the southwest, okay, in Nigeria. Talk of southwest, talk of south. In the southwest, you have states such as Lagos State. I believe many of you know Lagos, because it's very common, and Lagos is like very big. Now, I'll be giving you guys some illustrations, real illustrations, about some of the places I'm talking about. So you see how it looks like. Lagos is like a very, very big city in Nigeria, and not just in Nigeria, even in the whole of West Africa, okay? And it's a very industrious place, and a lot of things happen in Lagos, basically. You know, I think why Lagos is like that and more popular, because it has the ports, one of the main ports into Nigeria, okay? Port locations into Nigeria. So definitely a lot of shippings, products coming through that place, a lot of businesses, international business transactions and all that. There are foreigners that also live in Lagos a lot, yeah, because it's also a very nice place. There are beautiful places in Lagos, like you talked about Victoria Island. Is it Victoria Island, right? You have Banana Island and all those very wonderful tantalizing places. We have them in Nigeria. So Nigeria is not as local as some people may think, okay? The problem we have in Nigeria, the major challenge we have in Nigeria, is actually with regards to leadership to some extent, you understand? Yeah, we have not really been lucky to have very, very, considerate leaders in some arms of the government. So that should be one of the major problems we have in Nigeria, but we are hoping that things get better. They talk of security. In fact, there's a lot of security threats in the country now, which I may not even be able to begin to say now. You understand? Like, this is the truth. So the reason why I'm sharing this also is for those who are believers and you have hope and you believe in praying, please pray for our dear country, my dear country, Nigeria. Since you guys ask me as Malaysians, my very good friends, because most of my subscribers are Malaysians, say you want to know about Nigeria, tell us about your country, show us pictures of the beautiful things in Nigeria, the touristic areas in Nigeria, is Nigeria safe and all that. Well, here you have it, guys. It's not going to be a long video, but that's just an introduction to my country. If you want to know more, you can ask me more specifically, what are the things you really want to know? I will make some videos for you. Maybe you want to know about the culture, my country, the languages. We have a lot of languages and a lot of cultures, okay? But the three major ethnic groups in Nigeria are what? We have the Yoruba, the Igbo, and the Hausa, okay? Yoruba, Igbo, and Hausa. These are the three major ethnic groups in my country, Nigeria, okay? So, and Nigeria has beautiful people. These are some of the positive sides of Nigeria. Like, if you see a real Nigerian, like a real ambassador of Nigeria, definitely they are very friendly, they are very kind, they are very open, hospitable, and willing to help. That's just the truth about the country. Forget about the negative aspect you may be hearing of people saying a lot of things. Like, I've seen a lot of comments in some of my videos and I just smile and pass through, you know. Some of those people are looking for attention, maybe because of their experiences or whatever they have had, the news and all that. Some people come to my comment section and they are saying, ah, Nigerians are scammers, go back to your country, do this, do that. And, well, I'm not discouraged. It's not a new thing, okay? So I'm not discouraged. You guys may not know, but definitely as a YouTuber, especially if you are growing, you have two groups of people, okay? Or three. One are the supporters, okay? Those who are very genuinely supporting your channel, which are you guys now, I know, many of you. And two are the what? The neutral ones. Those ones, they are just there. They are not either to support or to pull you down. And then you have the third group, which are the most dangerous groups of audience on this YouTube channel or any social media, especially YouTube, because we broadcast to, you know, different people all over the world. And those third groups are the negative fellows, okay? The haters, those that don't really want your progress so much like that, and that always want to say something bad just to pull you down. I'm not surprised. I'm a cybersecurity fellow, so these kind of threats are not new to me. These are what we call what? Cyber threats, okay? And there's a module we call familiarity with cyber threats, which definitely I'm familiar with some of the cyber threats already, so I'm not really so concerned about that. But anyways, that's by the way. So yes, many people think Nigeria is, you know, it's a breed of bad people, you know, that try to bring up people that are what? Not useful to society, that are not useful to society and all that. Definitely that's very wrong. Am I not useful to society? Are you not enjoying me? That's why you kept following me. Some of you have been following me since this channel was established, and that's very, very beautiful. That's because this is the true, genuine nature of a real Nigerian, okay? Not all, in fact, the percentage of Nigerians that are doing the bad things that you hear in some places or all that are very, very small. That's just the truth compared to the good people. But unfortunately, because of the nature of the country and the fact that we are not really having leaders that are really serious and ready to fight insecurity and some of these social vices that's affecting the country, then you see everything just looks somehow. So we are not denying the fact that, okay, there are a lot of challenges here and there in the country as we speak currently. In fact, one of my friends, you know, there was something that just happened just yesterday or just a few hours, because compared to Nigeria's timing, and I'm really sad making this video, okay? But yeah, what shall we do? We're just praying. So just help us to continue praying. If you really love me, you love my channel, you love what I do, and I believe you're going to love my country as well. So that's the main thing. Just pray for Nigeria that there will be peace in the country, and all the people that are not supposed to be there to lead the people, that what God Almighty what we uproot them one by one. That is the sincere prayer we are praying for. I'm an advocate for truth. I'm an advocate for, you know, for peace, and I'm an advocate, okay, for good governance and good leadership. I'm not going to insult any authority. I'm not going to insult any leadership. That's not how I was brought up, and that's not what I believe, you know, as a believer. But I'm going to speak when it warrants to what to speak. So for you people watching from abroad, from different parts of the world, maybe you're Nigerians over there, don't give up totally on the country. We have loved ones there, we have family there. If anything happened to them, we ourselves, we will not actually what be at rest. I remember what happened some times ago, you know, to my own family, okay, and it was really, really critical. So yeah, and then when I hear other people, you know, give their own experiences, share their experience of what's happening to them and around them, I feel so bitter. I feel so sad. You know, things that are not supposed to happen in the same nation actually is happening in that part of the world. So that is the update about my country. But apart from all those negative things, Nigeria is a beautiful country. We are hoping that security issues will be solved amicably, so that by the grace of God, I can invite any of you to my country, you know, and take you for holidays and all that. But yeah, Nigeria is still nice. People still visit the country, you know, we still have tourists. It's not as bad as some places. That's just the truth. But even if it is just 1/4, okay, a quarter of bad thing that is happening in the country, it is something that needs to be rebuked. That is why I am rebuking it openly today. But in reality, it's a beautiful place. If you go to Nigeria, I'm telling you, you're going to enjoy yourself. There are a lot of foreigners that have gone there, and they have brought back very great, great, great testimonies. Of course, the major people that make up a country are the people. So if the people are so good, so kind, if 90% of the people are very wonderful and beautiful people, then of course, it's a beautiful country. What do you think? I'm not going to be among those that will pull out the country. No, whatever we are doing is for the betterment of the nation. And I really wish and pray to see my country become better once again. What about you? What are your thoughts about Nigeria? What you have been hearing about the country and what you have had so far? Do you think it's a nice country? Do you think it's a beautiful country? Do you think things will get better? You know, do you think we're going to be actually free indeed very soon? Join us in prayers and keep encouraging. Put a nice comment down below. And feel free. You can put any comment you want, definitely. It's a free world. But today I'm talking about my country. Let me just round up as I make a little comparison. Malaysia, on the other hand, is a very beautiful country, I must confess. Like, sometimes when I look at what's happening in Malaysia and how things are going, you know, how they are very effective, you know, the security, the safety, you know, the upgrades, the development, and all that, then I begin to wonder in my heart, where did we get it wrong back there? This country, they got their independence not so long. The difference between Malaysia's independence and Nigeria's independence is just very, very little, very small. Let me just confirm the date when Malaysia got her independence. So you see, Malaysia gained her independence on September 16th, 1963, guys, which is 3 years after Nigeria gained her own independence, October 1st, 1960. So, in reality, you should be expecting that other side should have gone even farther and better than this other side. But it's the opposite, guys. I must tell you the truth. Of course, talk about population. Nigeria is quite populated, more than Malaysia. Nigeria has over 200 million people, while Malaysia has around 30-something million people, okay, in population, apart from tourists and all those other foreigners and all those people. But their own population is around 33 or something, I think, yeah, 3 or something million. So yeah, but that's not a problem. I think the population should actually be one of the strengths, am I right? Like, you look at China. You see, I've been to China personally, and forget about all the controversies that people are saying here and there. I have been there face to face, and I have seen the country. At least I have been to two parts of the country, two major cities in the country, which is Guangzhou and Beijing. And I can tell you that their population is actually one of their strengths. Yes, China is a very beautiful place, and those guys are just thinking of forward, 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 forward. That is why you can see how things are moving well there. I think one of the major problems about some countries that are not really making progress because of corruption. You know, whether you like it or not, there's a lot of corruption, and things are supposed to have been done and addressed are not addressed properly and amicably. So what do you think? I'm not somebody that really love to talk about politics and all that, but that's just the truth. And like in some of these countries now, their laws are very strict, and that is why things are moving very smoothly. Even if people are going to steal, they will steal with common sense. Have you heard that before? Stealing with common sense, you know. But they still do the right thing, they still develop their country, they still make their country look nice and attractive to other people. And that's why we are here. Because there's peace of mind here, you know. They have light 24 hours, you know. They have good roads. It's a very secure country, you know. I can keep on telling you a lot and a lot and a lot of this country, Malaysia. But anyways, that's not the center of the discussion today. Yeah, that's it about Nigeria, a very beautiful country, a hopeful country. We are hopeful for the best. And this is our national anthem of my country. Arise, O compatriots, Nigeria's call, obey. to save our father's land with love and strength and faith. The labor of our heroes past shall never be in vain. To serve with heart and might, one nation bound in freedom, peace and unity. That's it, guys. We hope the lyrics of the song will make impact in that nation as soon as possible. Anyways, I still love my country because my people are there, my parents are there, my loved ones are there. I still love my country. My friends are there, you know. I still love my country and I hope to see it better very soon. Let me know your comment about this video in the comment section below. Your thoughts, what do you think? Would you like to visit Nigeria in the future? There are a lot of places there, I'm telling you, so many I cannot begin to mention. Okay, would you like to visit Nigeria? What is your prayer for my country? Do you think things will be better? And yeah, send your best wishes. I love you guys so much. I love Malaysia, I love Nigeria, I love Malaysians, I love Nigerians. Much love and God bless you. Stay positive no matter the situation. Don't let anybody steal your joy. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.